I speak in prisons, and I do a lot of public library speaking and high school speaking as well. And a lot of times, I'm brought into areas where you might have kind of in a low economic situation. You have places where, you know, books may not be the first choice of an activity, you know, and that, you know, the educational goals for maybe the students aren't necessarily as high as you would see elsewhere. So because of that book, I end up getting into the nice, squeaky, difficult parts, you know, the dirty zones maybe sometimes. And I like it, you know, because they're great. One of the things about these guys is they're really honest. And if they like the book, they'll come up to you and say so. So once, and it was a nice town in New Jersey. And this is a fairly typical kind of story. So I was speaking there, and I was speaking about this book, among other books. And there was a tough-looking kid in the back. You know, kind of had his head lowered down, looking up through his eyebrows the whole time. And then there was this young, sort of blonde, really enthusiastic person sitting next to him. And then there was this, you know, sort of middle-aged woman. And so finally I talked, and everybody left, and they didn't leave. So I kind of thought, you know, this is a little odd. So I sort of walked down toward them, and I said hello. And then the mother was like, stand up. And the blonde, stand up. So the guy gets up, and God, he was just, you know, he was a pretty strong kid. And so the mother says, tell him, tell him. So he kind of looks up, he finally looks me in the eye, and he goes, this is the first book I ever finished, you know. And the young woman was his reading teacher from school, and the mother was just so proud that he had finished a book and brought him down here, and the reading teacher was young and enthusiastic, you know, so she hadn't been worn out, you know, and he was there. And then he said, I would have given it to my friend to read, but he's in prison. I said, well, you know, we could send him. You know, we'll send them a copy. We'll take care of that, which we did. And so, but that kind of, you know, little story is just amazing to me to see this kid come forward and to have a book and then to hope, you know, to walk away, you know, thinking, well, maybe that's the first of many books. That's really where we want to go. So I see a lot of that with this book. It's a teen boy book that really seems to want to be, you know, the first book through the door.